Welcome back to Talkback. We posed a question to our friends on Twitter and Facebook. Should the Philippine government have acted sooner in repatriating OFWs in Libya? Let's read some of their answers. Christian Francisco says, ultimately, it still boils down to logistical concerns. We just do not have the resources that will allow us to do this immediately. But this should be a lesson for everyone. There is such a thing as contingency planning, and measures should have been mapped out ahead of time. Jesus Belolo says, napakarami pang migrant workers na iba't ibang lahi ang napapabayaan ng kanilang respective governments. I think our government is doing great sa pagsaklolo sa mga OFWs natin. A comment from Rhea Fariñas, the Philippine government should have acted sooner, but their wait-and-see attitude prevails. OWA contributions are worth a lot of funds if they were talking about resources. And finally, Janice Paulino says, our government could have acted from the very start, and only if we had enough funds for the repatriation of the OFWs. Let's hope they can find other means. Hindi lang sapat na sabihin, kulang tayo sa pondo, kaya mabagal ang proseso ng repatriation dahil buhay ng mga libo-libong mga Pilipino na nasa Libya ang nakasalalay dito. We also asked the men and women in the streets if they think the government should have acted sooner in repatriating OFWs in Libya. Here's what they had to say.
Para po sa akin, hindi po sapat yung ginagawa na pagtulong ng ating gobyerno, sapagkat nakikita naman po natin na sa kabila po ng kaguluhan dun sa ibang bansa, yung pagtulong po nila ay mabagal.
I think it would be right naman if the, you know, if the Philippine government would fetch them from directly from Libya, at least you know, they could help the OFWs.
Hindi nga sapat, pero may mga marami din mga ibang problema na katulad ng dapat the first place, dapat hindi sila mag-abroad, dapat nakaka-provide yung gobyerno ng mga needs nila ng jobs, yun, para hindi na sila kailan mag-abroad pa.
Para sa akin, hindi pa sapat yung nakikita namin ginagawa ng gobyerno. Konting kilos pa, 2 weeks na po yun. So dapat ngayon may progression na, kaso nga lang wala pa.
Yeah. With us, Senator Miguel Zubiri, Labor and Employment Secretary Rosalinda Baldoz. We are also joined by Jemmuel Alunen. He is a safety officer of the Vinci OEA Construction Grant Project in Libya. And we also have Lito Soriano. He is the president of LBS E-Recruitment Solution, which sends Filipino workers to Libya. And we have Susan Ople, president of the Blas Ople Policy Center, which handles labor and migration concerns. Let me ask you, Jemmuel, dun sa naging experience mo, ikaw ay swerte at nakabalik ka dito at organisado yung iyong kumpanya, dun sa mga kaibigan mo, ano sa palagay mo ang kakulangan na dapat pagbutihin dun sa sistema ng pag-aalerto sa mga kasamahan mong Pilipino sa Libya?
Yung mga naiwan po?
Yung mga naiwan. Ano ang kailangan nilang pagbutihin pa, yung ating embahada, yung pamamaraan ng pakikipag-usap sa inyo at pagtulong?
Ang totoo po niyan ay yung embassy should, the Philippine embassy should coordinate with the employer at maging serious po sila sa pag-assess ng situation. Yan po talaga ang susi niyan eh. Dahil yung mga worker naman, no, kahit gustong-gusto na nilang umalis, naming umalis, kung ayaw po nung employer pa, eh naghihintay pa ng lumala siguro, ano, eh wala rin po mangyayari.
Okay. So importante yun, yung Philippine Embassy, seryosong nakikipag-usap sa mga employer nitong mga OFW. Yes, Lito?
Well, doon sa experience namin with Vinci, nung nasa critical point kami ng decision-making process, isang issue na hindi namin ma-resolve is that ang sabi sa akin ng headquarters ng Paris, do you have an illegal position already of your government? Are we not going to violate any legal procedure if we are going to move your nationals? Because as per our office in Libya, there's no clear instruction yet that we can move your nationals, Mr. Soriano. So with that situation, I went to DFA on Monday and talked to Ambassador Andaya, who was preparing to move to Somalia towards Tripoli. And I said, sir, we need the legal basis for the action that will be taken by our employers. We have already set already into motions procedures, and we believe we are able to follow our crisis procedures. But to them, they want to be clarified. So, mm-hmm. yun ang isang quandary po namin noon. Kaya ginawa namin po ni, sabi niya Lito, may naputol din ang kontak namin sa embassy, nahirapan kaming kumontak. Kaya yung assessment namin to whether how serious the situation is, wala pa at this time, wala. So, ang ginawa namin is that pinuduce namin lahat yung mga passport ng mga tao namin doon. Dala-dala yun ni Kwan, nasa option 2 kami. Dala-dala yun ni Ambassador Ndaya at yung team yun na 6 yung passport namin. In case na magkaabutan sila doon, di mapastrack namin yung issue ng travel documents. Because at this time, we don't know what to proceed. Kasi hindi makalapit yung mga tao namin sa embassy. Hindi rin yung embassy makapunta sa lugar nila because of the crisis situation. May mga barilan, may mga nagtumatak, may mga lumalakad na makuha.
Susan, bakit kailangan ng legal basis para, bakit humihingi ng legal basis itong employer nila based in France? Kung well, magagalaw nila, do
unang,
you know?
Unang-una kasi ang nangyari yata is that hindi na rin sila dumaan sa embassy eh. So gusto rin naman siguro nila na well, ililikas din kasi yung workers natin from Libya to Paris, from Paris to Manila. So, syempre, yung company, which is a very responsible company, wants to make sure that all bases are covered.
Secretary Baldoz, is there something here that needs to be fine-tuned as far as the legal basis for the French company that's working, that has workers in Libya, before they move them en masse?
I think what they have in mind is whether the Philippine government has already made a decision based on their own security assessment on whether, again, voluntary or so-called mass or forced evacuation, in which case they would feel that they can already activate their contingency plan.
Senator Zubiri.
To make an educated guess, the legal framework that they're worried about is probably violations of their contracts. So if they repatriate without, let's say, the go signal of the Philippine embassy stating that, yes, it's dangerous there now, please send our workers back home, then they violate the contracts of the workers. Basically, you're moving them out before the end of the term of their contract. So as an educated guess, I think they're worried about that legal binding contract that the workers signed with the company. That's why the Philippine government should act quickly. Most first world governments and developed countries, they come up already with the assessment plan. As Ma'am Susan had mentioned earlier, meron po silang nakatingin dun on the situation on the ground. Pag red alert na yun, talagang they will get in touch with the embassies and tell them, okay, time to move out. Because there's fighting in the streets, the government has collapsed. In this case, we lost half of Libya. Half of Libya already went to rebel territory or rebel control about 2 weeks ago. Then this broke away from the Gaddafi faction. So by that time, we should have already set the warning signals and told our people to come, at least had our embassy people tell the employers to send their people home.
Send their people home or relocate them to some safe areas nearby. Is that an option that is the more prudent option and the more economical option for both the employer and the Philippine government? Susan?
Yeah, I think the immediate concern is really